The RCOH process is a jigsaw puzzle, and all the pieces have to be aligned to make this efficiently work. IDS is a big initiative now that is it's at the ground floor.
This is actually one of the first ships that we've had a large presence of integrated digital shipbuilding on the RCOH program. One of the biggest things that we're seeing from is that it's actually taken the way we've always done it before, and it's allowing us to be a little bit more efficient, a little bit more effective, a little bit quicker in our day-to-day operations. Very specifically to the radar tower, one of the things that RCOH never had in the past was a 3D product model. So we were actually able to take that 3D product model and not just utilize it for engineering and planning, but actually put it into the hands of our craftsmen. So our craftsmen were actually able to see kind of an early stage of the radar tower, even doing some testing very early on in the availability. So when it actually came to the ship, we're in a much better situation. We're a lot farther ahead, and a lot of really what IDS allowed us to do is not just the new products, not just the digital product, but allowed us to think outside the box of how can we reinvent the RCOH program.
All the different trades are involved with it. It makes it a lot easier because on those 3D drawings, I can see more of the other trades, you know, like piping or ventilation or something like that that could be in my way, putting up a light or connection box or anything like that. And I have it all on one drawing. Instead of getting multiple drawings, going back and forth, trying to figure out which drawing I need, where I need, where it's just at my fingertips and I'm just rotating the drawing around. This is my third RCOH, and you can see the progression as far as new technology coming in, new ideas, everything to make it easier, more simpler, so we can get these boats back into the fleet so we can help defend our country.